Long time ago, a baby was born. The pride to the globe. A bouncing and life-kicking pretty baby girl.
Badilika is all about behavior change and sexual reproductive. Hapo ndo sasa tunadeal on the issue of early marriages, teenage pregnancy, tuko na child prostitution, tuko na FGM, tuko na child labor. So in that area tunadeal na mostly young people from schools because they are also affected with such issues on sexual reproductive health. So our main idea of the program is to go to school tunaongelesha watoto. Na whenever they have such cases wanakama wana report hapa wanapata usaidizi, like on the FGM ina affect most of the young girls within the Korogocho, but especially Muslim community ni bado on that practice. So we talk to the parents, at least was to push the FGM by kuonesha the disadvantages of the cut. Now, as I'm speaking, I'm one of the victim of the FGM, so I know the disadvantages that wasichana wana go through when wana pata those practices.
I think the right time for change, for acceptance, doesn't mean resignation. It means understanding that something is what it is, or we rather, what someone wants it to be.
Naitwa James Mbulo, mini presenter na pia reporter Coach FM. Na tukitokishia FGM, kwanza kuna tribes mwamba ambazo na practice FGM. Niki mention tu a few, tuko na Masai's na pia tuko na Somalis. Na disadvantage ya FGM kwa wasichana wetu ni kwanza, sana sana kuna msichana kuna high risk ya kupata HIV, because napata kwamba since inafanywa traditionally, ile kisu jamaa ambaye anatumia kukata huyo msichana atatumia kukata the another girl, na ujui vile huyu msichana likatwa kwanza vile alikuwa. Then another risk, kuna hii complication during birth. Msichana kikatwa time ya birth, wengi wao kuwa na shida tu sana. Then apart from hiyo, pia kuna hii msichana na luzile ajia sex. Ha? Msichana kisha mkata, ile ajia sex, ana lose tu kabisa, kabisa, kabisa. Then advice yangu tu kwa wale, kwa zile communities ambazo zina practice hiyo FGM, mimi ni ile tu kuwaomba, to stop, tuweze kusave wasichana wetu from hizo vitu ambazo zimetaja, things kama HIV, things kama niseme inaitwaje, complication during birth. Then pia tu kwa government, ile tu kuweza ku create awareness to such communities, because saizi we are not in the traditional world, saizi tuko kwa digital world.
To talk about female genital manipulation, this is a practice that involves cutting a part or the whole part of the external genital part of the female. And basically, it can result to very serious injuries to the mother, and some of clients die during actually the procedure. And also we have witnessed mothers who develop very serious bleeding, what we call postpartum hemorrhages, during delivery, resulting from tears, which usually occurs because the perineum has already been having scars resulting from the FGM. The other thing is some of the girls who have been done this practice are done at a very tender age by the act, and it is not reversible. I greatly condemn the act of female genital manipulation, because this is a violation of human rights and also for the right to live.